हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ प्रोफेसर तुषार गुजराती फ्रॉम एस एन डी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग येवला। टुडे विल स्टडी एक्चुएटर्स बट दे आर न्यूमेटिक एंड हाइड्रोलिक टाइप। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी स्टडीड इलेक्ट्रिकल सिस्टम एक्चुएटर्स लाइक डीसी मोटर, सर्वो मोटर, स्टेपर मोटर, सोलेनॉइड्स। नाउ विल स्टडी न्यूमेटिक एंड हाइड्रोलिक सिस्टम्स। सो व्हाट हैपेंस इन न्यूमेटिक एंड हाइड्रोलिक सिस्टम? Pressurized fluid in a pipe is used to generate, regulate, transmit forces. So pressurized fluid is used in a pipe to generate, regulate and transmit the forces. Hydra, that is water is used, and pneumatic air is used. So application is transmission, steering, brakes, suspension, airplane landing, aircraft, helicopters, pneumatic drills, grinders, pores, riveting machines. So there are many applications available for this pneumatic and hydraulic systems. So this is one hydraulic system is shown over here. So you can check here. So here you can check the diagram. Now this is the actuator over here. So what happened, because of this application of load, the fluid flows in this direction, okay? It flows through this direction control valve and goes to this oil tank, okay? And again this filtered with the help of this filter, and from this pressure regulator again given to this actuator, okay? So like this hydraulic system works. So that this load can be moved up and down. So hydraulic system components you might know. So it consists of many components, like cylinder is there, direction control valve is there to control this movement, motor pumps are available, filter is available for filtering, reservoir is used for reservoiring the oil, and pressure regulator is useful for regulating the pressure. So according to this direction control valve, this piston inside the cylinder can be extended or retracted. So like this hydraulic system works. So here operation is started from turning motor on, okay? So in pneumatic system we use compressed gas like air. So here we need air compressor, okay? So air from atmosphere is taken, filtered, then air compressor compresses the air, then through this air cooler sent to storage reservoir, and storage reservoir the direction control valve controls the movement of this cylinder, okay? And according to this load can be moved up and down, okay? So here the compressed gas is used as a air. So there is some difference between pneumatics and hydraulics. So first, it's as a fluid it uses pressurized liquid, okay? Hydraulics uses pressurized liquid while pneumatics uses a compressed air. Now second comparison, pressures of up to 700 bar are used in oil hydraulics. So pressure can be used up to 700 bar, but in pneumatic system we can use up to very small 5 to 10 bars. Now third comparison, it is designed as a closed system. In most cases typically they are built as open system. So usually hydraulic system is open system, but pneumatic system leakage has impact on the system. Because of leakage the system gets slowed down. Now fourth number, valves are difficult to use. So in hydraulic system valves are difficult to use, but in pneumatic system the operation of valve is simple. Because of air pressure valves gets open and close very easily. Hydraulic systems are heavier in weight, pneumatic systems are lighter in weight. Here in hydraulic system you check point number 6, pressurized liquids are delivered by pumps. So pumps deliver pressurized liquids. But in pneumatic system we require compressors to supply compressed gases. In hydraulic system, the system is unsafe to fire. The system is unsafe to fire. But in pneumatic system, there is no fire dangers in the system. In hydraulic system, lubrication is done automatically because oil is used everywhere, therefore lubrication is done automatically. But in pneumatic system, we require special lubricating arrangements. So special lubricating arrangements are required in pneumatic systems. So you can see here some hydraulic and pneumatic linear actuators are shown here. So how they get extended or retracted? So here you can see that because of hydraulic fluid pressure, the piston gets extended, okay? And there is one port is provided so that fluid gets returned back to the reservoir, okay? Similarly, if hydraulic fluid pressure is coming from this side, then the piston gets retracted and this fluid gets returned back to the reservoir, okay? So like this it works. So these are double acting cylinders. So these are double acting cylinders, and for single acting cylinders shown on first diagram, we provide their springs, okay? Springs are provided. So because of this spring pressure, the piston moves towards, or piston gets retracted back because of these springs, okay? So there are different types of linear actuators are available. So first one is single acting cylinder. It moves in one direction only and it gets retracted back with the help of these springs. Second one is double acting cylinder. So it can move in both the direction. It can be extended or retracted automatically. Next is double acting cylinder with through piston rod. So piston rod is provided over there. Next is double acting cylinder with single non-adjustable cushioning. So there is non-adjustable cushioning is provided. In the next, adjustable cushioning is there. And in the last, adjustable cushioning both the ends. It is available at both the ends. So like this, there are different types of linear actuators are available. So now up to this point, we have studied all types of sensors and actuators, okay? So what is selection criteria for these sensor and actuators? So this is one important slide. Now, selection criteria for sensors and actuators. So first is control of motion. So how you are going to control the motion? It is linear, rotary, okay? So depending upon that, we have to select the particular sensor and actuator. So again, point is impact of cleanliness and safety. So if we want safety and cleanliness, then we go for electrical actuators, because this hydraulic and pneumatic creates some unsafety while working. That's why we go for electrical actuators. Maintenance and durability is also important for any type of sensor and actuator. So that also we should understand. Noise in the environment. Suppose you are using particular actuator motor, and if that motor is making very noise, then it is not suitable for some applications. So that's why you should understand noise and in the environment also. Energy efficiency. So how energy efficiency can get, that also you should understand. Energy efficiency. Space efficiency. So what kind of efficiency you get in the space, how you utilize the space, this is also very important. So use, if you have less space, then you use small type of motors and sensors. Integration with other applications. So if you are using one application, so these sensors and actuators must get integrated with another application also, okay? So that you will not require much sensors and actuators for different applications. So thank you so much all of you for watching this video.